Also Elvin Bishop, we heard Roger McGuinn with Someone to Love, and also Chatham County Line covering Wilco's I Got You. At
the got original Delco AM FM stereo radio. They put these in a lot of things, Corvettes, trucks, everything in the 79, 78 on up. This one's going in a 1984 Chevrolet Blazer. And we've took it and we've done a complete cleanup on it and a full Aurora Design conversion. It's got AM, FM, stereo, four channels out, 45 watts a channel. It's got pre-outs on the back so you can add a sub and an amp to your rear speakers if you want it. It's got auxiliary in. This is your harness you'll be getting. Plug in auxiliary in right here. You'll get a male-to-male cord with it. And you plug any device into it you want to, your phone, MP3, satellite radio, CD changers, XM radios, anything that's got a head that plays music. It also has USB port. That's your lower part here. This comes with it. You mount it around the hole in this harness. Plays a thumb drive, which comes with it, with this video on it, some music. Also will charge your phone, your devices. It's push-button operated. The push-button operates USB and your phone. It has also got Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, voice command, voice assistance. This radio here will scan your stations for you while you're going down the road. It also has voice ID. Everything works like it always originally used to, all your push buttons.
Oh, most certainly. People in front of me in 40 million on TV.
And I think what happened is that I stepped into it. Has a built-in fader.
A civic poet, something that I have
front speakers, so rear speakers, that's full-time fader. Also has balance built in your toner.
I just started writing poems.
You got treble and bass like you've always had.
Writing poems like, for example, after the Boston Marathon bombings, after the Pulse shooting.
And you have balance built in that control. I'll demonstrate that for you. Right now you're on FM. And of course, your slider bar, if you want to go to AM, you just slide it over. Takes you to AM radio. Back, takes you right back to FM stereo. Pull your presets out. You got presets. Don't a lot of people listen to AM anymore, so. But it has that ability to do that. First thing we're going to do is scanning your stations. If you're going down the road, you're cruising, whatever, you want to let the radio, it'll find a station for you. I'll show you how to lock on one. All you do is take your tuning knob and turn it up twice.
Scanning for stations.
Now it's going to start scanning for stations without the needle moving.
So, of the book in a way, which is.
And then I'll show you how to lock on the one and actually even find that station where it's located on the dial. So you can pull out a preset and set it if you like it.
To be holy. God expects us to be holy. First.
Say you like that station there, all you do is take the tuning knob and turn it once.
Station hold.
Now it will lock on that station, or as soon as you say that, if you want to find it, it'll go quiet till you find it. Pull out a preset and you got it. It'll do this on AM and FM. So it'll search for your own station, that way you ain't got to drive down the road and fool with the radio the whole time. You can concentrate on driving. That's pretty neat. Auxiliary in, you just pull out your little cord. You might have it hidden in your glove box or whatever. And all you do is just plug it in. Well, come back here, cord. And you can take any device you want to, plug it in, and just turn it on. It automatically changes over.
Imagine this song as you're taking that.
The color in device. You got a little operating LED down here. It changes multiple colors. You see it's green now. That means you're on auxiliary in. Anytime you want to go back to radio, just simply turn that device off. You don't even have to unplug it. And then 20 seconds, the radio will automatically change back over if you don't touch it. If you don't want the 20 seconds of dead air, just turn the radio off and right back on. It cancels out the 20 seconds. It remembers where you're at. We're going to put new speakers. We got two to go in the dash. We got two 6x9s to go in the rear. We're also going to add a sub, which is a powered sub. I really like them. It has a control that up towards your dash. You can control the volume of your sub once you get it set up. It's full package, wiring and all, going with this one. All right, we've done the scanning and all. We're going to do. We're going to log in our Bluetooth to do the initial pair up, and you will too. And once you pair up your phone, come up on Bluetooth there. And once you pair up your phone, every time you get in, we'll do a test to make sure it finds the phone. But you're going to do the initial pair up. Let's let her help us out. We're going to hold this button down.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Showed up on her phone. All we got to do is tap on it. She'll tell us when it's done.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
All right. Now we're going to do a voice command. You have two mics. You get one to get a little close to in case your blazer is a little bit loud. You also have one built right here in the face. I found these to be very good. We're going to do a voice command. We're going to music on my phone. Or you can do anything. Call home, look up a restaurant, whatever your smartphone is capable of doing. Nowadays they do everything. There's two ways of doing it. This push button also works with these knobs. We're going to do it first with this. We're going to hold it down and bring Siri up on our phone. Play music. Now we're going to music on my phone. We're going to get it there so you can see how to operate it. If you want to advance your songs, just press the button once. Twice to back up or repeat. You can also do it with the volume knob. Turn it up. Back it up. So you got multiple ways of doing it. Now a phone call comes in, you can answer the call by pressing this once and talk, or turn your tuning knob up one click and answer your call and talk. When you're done, you let the phone hang up, it'll go back to doing whatever the radio was doing, or you can end the call by turning it down or pressing this twice if you want to cut the call off early. I usually just let mine hang up and the radio goes right back to doing what I had it doing. I told you there's multiple ways. We held this down to bring our phone up to tell it what we wanted it to do. You can also do it with the volume knob by turning the volume knob up twice. Up. One, two. Stop music. Put it in pause. Going right back to radio.
Not only outdated, but also irrelevant.
So now you can do it at any time. Now what we're going to do, we're going to turn the radio off. Wait a few minutes, we're going to make sure it finds the phone when I turn it back on. Now it will take multiple devices. It'll always pick number one. So if you're a primary driver, that's one you want to do, and then you can do a second one in case somebody else is driving your truck. They can have that too. We want to turn it back on, make sure our Bluetooth is connected.
Tickets today, be part of a full day.
Bluetooth connected.
Partners at TV.
Found our phone. That's pretty neat. Now we're going to do the USB to it. Going to plug this in, go straight to it. Got a little storm going on. A little rumbling. Troubling bass like you've always had. Work our USB here or here. Back up, repeat. Here, back up. Now we're going to show you how to work the balance. The balance is built in your fader, and your fader has a center notch right there. All you're going to do is take your fader to that center notch and go counterclockwise, like a 12 to 10 motion. She's going to come over and say in the balance mode, balance adjust.
Balance adjust.
Now we can start switching back and forth. Right side, left side. When we're done with it, we balance it out, let her set it.
Balance set.
So now you ain't got to worry about that, all you got to worry about is treble and bass. Now, the push button, if you want to go back to radio on your own USB, just hold it down 1 second, put it in pause, go right back to radio. Same thing going down the road, you listen to radio, you whatever. You want to go to USB, hold it down 1 second, go right back to USB. Depends on how long you're down, whether it goes back the same song or not. Because, you know, it's pretty well computer age. These radios do not require 12-volt consistent. There's no batteries to change. Disconnect your battery on your blazer to store it or whatever. Put it back on. You ain't got to worry about presets. You ain't got to worry about it. It goes right back to doing what we had to do. Now, we went up twice on the volume knob to summon their phone up and tell it what to do. We want to go down twice on this to do the same thing as put this in pause. Down twice. It's in pause. Go right back to radio. We can bring it up the same way. Back on radio.
Fire members.
Now. In the gap with your monthly.
Two spirituals from a week happened Tuesday in the third. Several siblings became believers.
He was the one.
Original stereo light. Want to go back to USB at any time? You can hold this down 1 second, or you can turn this down twice. Right back to USB. Down twice, go right back to radio. Also, the last feature I'll show you, and sometimes you want to know where you're at on the radio, let it scan. If you let it scan, you're looking for a specific station. Volume knob up 3 times, she will tell you what station you're on. It's called Voice ID. 1, 2.
FM 92.5.
It will do this on AM and FM for you, which is pretty neat in case you're really looking for a specific station. That's your original Delco AM FM stereo radio for the trucks, Corvettes. They put these in a lot of things, Firebirds. This one come out of a truck. It's going back in a blazer. And full Aurora Design conversion. You're getting the speaker. You're getting everything. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Thank you.